What is ocean acidification, and how does it threaten marine life? The world currently produces around 35 billion tons of CO2 a year, and it does not seem to be decreasing. Much of these emissions go into the atmosphere and lead to the greenhouse gas effect, but around a quarter of CO2 caused by humans is actually absorbed by the oceans. Therefore, the more CO2 emitted, the more quantity of CO2 will be absorbed by the ocean. How does this lead to acidification? Well, the ocean has a pH of around 8.1. The pH measures acidity, and more precisely, the concentration of hydrogen ions. The more hydrogen ions present, the lower the pH and higher the acidity. When CO2 is absorbed by the oceans, it dissolves in the water and forms carbonic acid. Then, carbonic acid can dissociate into bicarbonate by losing hydrogen ions. And as we said, the more hydrogen ions, the more acidic the ocean gets. Since pre-industrial times, the pH of the ocean has decreased by around 0.1, which may not seem significant, but as the scale is logarithmic, it actually represents a 30% increase in acidity. I have put other videos in the description that also explain these more complex processes in detail. So why is this an issue? Well, an increase in acidity can have a devastating effect on marine ecosystems, especially calcifiers such as corals and sea urchins, as well as mollusks such as oysters. If we want to go into detail, reefs and mollusks will be heavily affected due to there being less calcium carbonate being formed, which is essential for these species to build strong skeletons and shells, as calcium now competes with hydrogen ions to associate with carbonate. This can sound complicated, but essentially, more CO2 equals more hydrogen ions and less calcium carbonate. Some species can somewhat adapt to acidification, but to do this, they allocate their energy to these mechanisms, which makes them weaker and less resilient to other threats such as pollution. Many fish and invertebrates rely on these structures such as coral reefs for habitat and feeding grounds, making these areas extremely biodiverse. So more acidic oceans might not kill non-calcifiers such as fish, but indirect effects of reef destruction will have a negative impact which could have ripple effects on food chains. This will be increasingly the case if most phytoplankton gets affected by acidification, with some species such as pteropods already being affected. So how does this impact us? Well, around 1 in 7 people in the world rely on aquaculture and fisheries as sources of food, with some areas of the world being especially reliant. Therefore, decreasing amounts of yields from mollusks such as mussels, as well as potentially fish, can have significant socioeconomic impacts. Some studies also show that not only are yields decreasing, but the quality of the yields is also decreasing with a reduction of proteins and lipids, which can exacerbate malnutrition in certain coastal communities. Ocean acidification can also negatively affect tourism in many countries, such as Australia, who receives 2 million tourists yearly who come only for the reefs. Finally, reefs also provide flood protection and protects coasts from erosion. So are there any solutions? Mitigating CO2 emissions and thus acidification is the most effective method. But the effects are already being seen, so we also need to implement adaptation and protection. Today, conventional methods include protection areas and decreasing other stress factors such as water pollution. Other less conventional methods include cultivating seaweed farms, as they act as a CO2 sink but only in a local range. Therefore, if cultivated close to vulnerable areas, it could decrease the acidity of the surrounding water. So, ocean acidification is clearly an issue that must be heavily mitigated, as it brings the destruction of marine ecosystems and a decrease in the benefits from ecosystem services. Unfortunately, other issues that this video hasn't touched, such as ocean warming and decreasing oxygen, can also synergize with acidification and can have even bigger effects. Feel free to comment any solutions you think could help. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video and want to learn more about climate and energy related issues, don't forget to subscribe.